algae bloom because of all the hot weather lately.
I can hear it all around the prop. That just ran out of rudder.
So there's even half of what's ran out of rudder.
What?
Babe, I can see weed getting sucked into the bow thruster. Don't use the bow thruster.
Aren't we literally at the like 3 miles from the last lock?
We're so close to the end.
I don't know, babe. I know.
Nick, I need you.
What's wrong?
I can't get us out. I need you. Up here now. Quick.
Yeah, there's smoke. I can see smoke.
I think we've got an engine problem, babe.
Just laughing about the fact that Nick has an Australian Siri, a woman, an Australian woman Siri, and I have an English male Siri, which is totally unintentional, by the way, and we just realised one day.
Mine was intentional. I missed you, so I got an Australian on there.
That's not true.
Yes, it is. I wanted an Australian when you weren't around. This is my love for you.
Yeah, so we're taking the piss out of Siri's Australian accent, and we realised that I actually cannot do a strong... I can't do a strong Australian accent, which makes no sense to anyone. But yeah. Your timer is set for 12 minutes. Is that what she said? Can you do it? No, no, no. Okay. You need to do something with Siri so that everyone...
Siri's doing something.
No, no, no. Siri can do two things at once.
Hey, Siri. What's the weather going to be doing today?
It's currently cloudy and 20 degrees in Montpowerlin. Expect mostly clear skies starting in the morning. Today's high will be 36 degrees and the low will be 20.
Anyway,
we had some comments.
It's time for 2 minutes with Ruby Rose. So it's going to be difficult for me to get fit that into 2 minutes. Anyway, we had some negative comments on our YouTube channel, didn't we? We did. We had some people saying, some mad buggers just like, I unsubscribed because of the tension between you two.
Yeah, and I'm re-watching the video going, I literally have no idea what you're talking about.
Yeah, I think he's got some issues. I think he had some issues. That was my take on it.
I think people, because we had a couple of comments being like, that was awkward or something.
Maybe they just don't get banter.
Yeah, I think that people mistake our banter for like actual arguments.
No, an argument is different. Two things. One thing, people are snowflakes. Nowadays, everyone gets offended by everything. Two, yeah. Some people just don't get humour. They just don't get it.
Yeah.
People just do not understand.
We're like just taking the out of each other, and then people are like, oh my God, you're arguing.
No, that's how it works.
Yeah.
Go and visit any Australian English household in the world, and that's what happens. Because we're curious, curious folk, we've actually been on board, 3 or 4 barges over the last month?
Yep.
No, some of the ones we've been on have been really well appointed.
Yeah.
Like luxury, high class apartments with really good joinery.
Yeah.
Yeah, we saw, what was it, a Piper?
Piper, yeah, they're our new favourite, aren't they?
Yeah, a Piper, but for those of you who haven't seen, go and look at Piper. And they've got
for the future.
Yeah, obviously for the future. Yeah, no, I want to sail off into the Pacific at 23 knots. cough, or splatter. In other news, I've managed to tear, I've literally torn the arse out of my trousers.
Yeah, go on, let's have a little look. Yeah, see, everyone should be very grateful that for once Nick is wearing his very, very nice stripy underpants.
Yes, yes. It's a rare treat to see my cheeks covered.
There you go. That looks absolutely idyllic. That vine, the vines covering their house, they're amazing. Yeah, and as an Australian, I'm just thinking about how many spiders are in there.
Oh, if that was in Australia, the owners would be dead, and their families would all be dead.
Due to what?
Some sort of degenerate ivy spider that would bite you, and then like 3 weeks later, your arms and legs would fall off, or something like that. Only in Australia. Oh, look at this little blue octopus walloped dead. Jellyfish dead. Spiders, lots of them dead. Sharks dead. Snakes dead. Even the bloody duck-billed platypus, poisonous. The only poisonous mammal. You know that?
Yeah, I didn't know that.
There's only one venomous mammal. Bloody in Australia.
But I don't think they can bite people, can they?
It's not their beaks.
Well, how do they poison you?
They've got these lovely little cute things, like little hands. Like you look them up, like you look like a little beanie baby doing all this. And then they got these fucking little talons that come out. They're like poisonous. Like why? I know that they said that, like, you know, the duckbill platypus was made up of all the bits in God's shop that he had left over. He's like, oh, I've got a beak left, I've got a bit of a beaver, I've got this, and I've got some little hands. So just stick it all together. It's like the Mr. Potato Head of the bloody animal world.
Aww.
Oh, and they're marsupials as well.
Yeah.
So, you know, so I can understand the marsupial, I can understand the kind of like the duck bill bit and that, but why make it poisonous? Like, well, what benefit is that to anyone?
But you have to give it some way to defend itself.
Well, a duck doesn't defend itself, does it? You don't find a duck with like a flamethrower coming out of its head.
No, but a duck can fly. A duck can fly. They can fly away.
Well, what about a beaver?
They can swim.
Well, so can a duck or a bloody platypus.
I don't know. Look, I'm not in charge of these things.
Like, what evolutionary mechanism needed this thing to suddenly develop venomous things?
Yeah, it does seem like a real hodgepodge. You've been going on about this, haven't you? Do you need like a cup of tea or something?
It's the tea. Where do you put my tea?
Hang on, the autofocus doesn't like you being so dark. So I think that's the end of that conversation. Blimey, check this place out. Moulin de L'Oréal. Don't. How come whenever I'm filming myself, I miss? Can you explain that to me?
We had been on the French canals for over 4 weeks. We had done 419 kilometres and 89 locks, and we were only two locks away from the final basin, after which we'll enter the river. We called ahead to the lock keeper who operated the final two locks, and he confirmed that we would be able to leave the locks and enter the river at 6 p.m. that night. All we had to do was get through those final two locks, only a few more hours, and we would be there. Everything seemed to be going perfectly smoothly, and then this happened.
Whoa!
That may be contributing to a loss of speed and power.
Yeah, that would explain why we're going so slowly. I'm losing steerage, so...
Yeah, don't let us get under one knot.
We're 1.3.
There's something going on. Yeah, we're dragging a ball of bloody oxygenating weed.
Yeah.
Ironically enough, the machine is jammed full of weed. They've managed to jam their own weeder. But it clogs everything up and then you end up like that. That poor bloody boat. God almighty, I hate seeing things like that. Yeah, there's something around the prop as we speak. I can feel there's a little shudder coming through the wheel.
Yeah.
It's weed again. It's not hampering speed too much. It normally makes it work its way clear. Let's see if I can just dislodge it now.
So at this stage, the whole situation was still fairly humorous. The weed was wrapping itself around our rudder and our prop, but although we were losing a little bit of steerage and speed, it really wasn't a major issue. However, it soon became a little bit less funny.
I can hear it vibrating.
before we push the button,
yeah,
I'm going to go and get off the boat and look at the rudders.
Yeah.
I've got something caught around one of my rudders. I mean, it's just, it's almost a futile exercise. There's so much.
I know.
Ran out of
rudder.
So there's even half of what's ran out of rudder.
Jeez, I'm suddenly very much looking forward to getting to the last lock. What? Maybe now's the time to make a formal complaint. There'll be an effort here.
They may not be happy with us putting the weed out.
Oh well, they can deal with it.
I got that. So much weed, I just can't avoid it though.
I know you can't.
Alright, will you helm, stay in the middle. Doing this all afternoon. Alright, go forward. Why is the idea?
I can hear it all around the prop. Should I put it in reverse for a sec?
Alright, go forward again. That was like ridiculous. We're gonna keep that speed up. That speed up, okay? And keep to the middle of the bloody canal.
Hey, I'm just drifting over. I don't want to use a bow thruster.
And then the inevitable happened.
Hi, Therese.
Yeah?
The engine's overheating. I don't know what the problem is. I think we've got an engine problem, babe.
Yeah, I know.
Right, we're safe, yeah?
Well, I've got the boat.
Okay. I'm going to be a while, so tie it to something. It's not the impeller. So my only thought is that the actual inlet is blocked.
Right.
Oh, I really didn't want to be doing this. Aren't we literally at the like 3 miles from the last lock? Not enough, and there's a lot of white smoke. There shouldn't be white smoke. That's it, perfect. That's exactly what I need. Thanks, Linda.
So do you know what the problem is?
I think we sucked a load of algae.
Yeah, well.
Into our water system.
Yeah, even I could have come up with that diagnosis. So we're kind of pulled over, trying to sort everything out, but my God, there's just so much in the water, it's just unbelievable.
Alright, let's go.
Let's see if
we can get
out
of here.
Okay, I'm on. Babe, I can see weed getting sucked into the bow thruster. Don't use the bow thruster. Yeah, there's smoke. I can see smoke. Oh, here we go. Yeah.
Middle of the river?
Yeah.
You steer into the middle of the river, this is essentially you're going to be doing this completely yourself, yeah?
Yeah, well, if I don't have any steerage.
Okay, I know, this isn't ideal. Just keep her in the middle, yeah?
I'll do my.
Kill the engine for me.
Kill the engine?
Kill the engine for me, yeah?
Alright.
Alright, Therese, start the engine. No, don't start the engine, Alright, Therese?
Yeah?
Start the engine.
I need you.
What's wrong?
I can't get us out. I need you. Up here now. Quick.
Yeah,
well, this is what happens.
We're
on a canal.
Yeah.
Your bathroom is gone.
Have you got water coming out?
Start the engine.
Start the engine.
We
got water?
Yep.
That was in the f***ing pipe.
Show that to the GoPro.
That was in the pipe. Are you okay doing that? Because it's easy, you're smaller than me.
Yeah, it's really okay, we've got one more automatic lock to go before we're in the kind of port area, before we go through the final two locks, which are manned, and we won't get through them until 5:30. A report or an update on the algae / weed situation. The VNF were actually at the last lock, so Nick, while he was at the helm, was chatting to the woman. And she was saying that it's an algae bloom because of all the hot weather lately. So, yeah, I was getting quite frustrated with the VNF, but I think that it's not due to neglect, it's because of this weather. There's just been an algae bloom. And she said that on this stretch, it's more shaded, there's more big trees, and so it shouldn't be as bad. And indeed it isn't, it's just back to normal canal water now. So Nick's taking a well on burn break, and I'm just harming us up to the last lock before we enter the port. And I tell you what, after this afternoon, I am suddenly very, very ready to get out into the river. Beautiful here, so pretty, very tranquil and peaceful and charming. And there's a little village there and a nice little cafe, restaurant, bar thing next door, and lots of big trees. It's all very nice. And alas, we're not going to stay here for longer than 2 hours. We are booked in to go through the lock at 5:30, and then we are going to spend the night in the pontoon on the other side in the river, so that we can make an early start tomorrow. I think we need to talk to the Ecclesia and get a local timetable. But I think we're going to be leaving at about 6 a.m. tomorrow. So yes, our last couple of hours on the canals. Mixed feelings. Last 10 kilometers or so have been quite challenging, and I'm glad that they're over. But overall, yeah, amazing experience, and this is a particularly beautiful spot to finish up. Yes. I'm just enjoying the moment. What is it?
I want to just talk to you about, because we're in a river now with tidal flow.
Yes.
So just to refresh our memories about how we do this.
Yeah.
So basically we need to observe the direction of flow of current. Yeah?
Yeah.
And we need to tie up into the tidal stream. Yeah?
Are you observing either of those things?
Huh?
What? So you need to turn around, is that what you're saying?
No, I don't know where the tidal stream is. The best
way
to
find it should be slack, is it?
No, the best way to look at tidal stream, it should be slack. Look at the movement of water around things like bridge pillars.
It does look slack.
Yeah, it looks pretty slack to me.
And that is our pontoon. There's a boat on it at the moment, but I'm hoping that they'll leave in a minute.
So, we've left the canals and we're tied up. But the pontoon that we are on, it's a floating pontoon, and it's literally just a waiting pontoon. There's no ladder to get down, which is actually a safety thing. You're meant to have a ladder because sometimes if you fall off, you can't get back in. And then there's a stone pathway, which is accessible at low tide. But then the pathway goes up into a little forest, an overgrown bramble and nettle forest, which normally I'd be like, all right, let's just sit back, open a few of the cold beers. However, there is a music festival with like a barbecue and beer and wine. And to celebrate, I want to go to the music festival. So we have got to contrive a method of getting there. The reason I'm tearing all this apart is because when we were in the Bahamas, hang on.
Oh babe, you're losing me.
We procured this.
Which looks like a...
It's a machete. So hang on. Just get it out of the measures. You'll need socks. I think I've been stung about, I don't know, 50 times.
What? Why didn't you ask me to get you socks?
I don't mind stinging nettles, babe. I grew up with them.
How very manly of you. Kelom, as our neighbour said.
Kelom.
Kelom. Well, I applaud you, and I think that this is a brilliant plan for tonight. Pour ce soir.
Pour ce soir. Oh, God, that's nice. Oh, the final stage of my plan is making sure I can get out.
Tonight. We won't have any water anyway by the time we get back.
Yeah, but you still need to be able to get up.
Yeah. Oh, come on, use your arm muscles. You do have some.
But there's nowhere to put my legs.
Put them on the ladder. You should have seen me trying to climb up on. I have no sympathy. Me trying to climb up onto the boat, like. When I was.
What is this attached to? The boat?
The boat.
Okay, yeah, that's easy.
It's basically a reenactment of me getting onto the bow of the boat. Stay back, ladies. He's mine.
All right.
All right.
Off you go. Now I'd hold the line if I were you. Don't pull that ladder off, otherwise we're going to be out. 2 and 8. Refreshing, it's lovely.
Right, it's a centre line.
Nah, I'm a badass.
Have you seen the middles of black again?
Just don't even look at them, just you're fine, you're covered. Oh, there's some thorns.
Oh yeah. Oh, well done, babe. Alright. Let me get my kit off before anyone comes along. Alright.
Tony stinger.
You need to keep a lookout.
Alright.
You have 3 jobs, film and keep a lookout. No, 3 jobs.
3 jobs, film, keep a lookout.
So if I look a bit dishevelled, it's because we had to put everything we own in a dry bag, swim across a river, go up some sort of like mad path that I carved with a machete to get to here. Here's my beer assistant. So we're here.
Yeah.
This is to celebrate, cheers. This is to celebrate us passing through the last lot. We've had aperitifs with our lovely French neighbours.
Yes.
And now there seems to be some Cuban music playing. There are a variety of delicious looking French food stalls for us to dine with.
Yeah, I'm getting excited.
And we've got beer. So the night is young.
Yeah.
Let's go and enjoy ourselves.
Let's
do it. I decided on more frites. We're going to have more frites to celebrate. There are huge pans of mull. Another stall over there is doing roasted duck. Chap behind me is doing oysters. So
So yeah, it's all pretty nice. A fitting end to a really amazing month in the canals.
What have we here?
More fruit.
Come on.
These good mussels.
This is a life. Eating more fruit at a French festival on a balmy Friday evening, having just finished the canals. We could not have contrived this. We couldn't have thought it up.
Well, it is time to get the mask back on the boat. It's a very nerve-wracking moment. The crane looks really small and, you know, it just all looks a bit precarious. But I'm sure they know what they're doing.